Hi and welcome to my first video about the nitrogen cycle. So we're going to start off by looking at a diagram of the nitrogen cycle. And all the nitrogen cycle actually is just a way of devising and showing how the nitrogen is distributed in the ecosystem. And it's a way of showing how we get from nitrogen found in one form to another. And so on this diagram, what you have here is anything that's in a box or rectangle illustrates nitrogen found in living things. You also, or in locations for instance, and anything in circles here, you have essentially in the forms that the nitrogen is found in. Anything with an arrow shows a process. And so if we look at the three places that it's found in living things, so for instance we've got here ammonium containing molecules, e.g. proteins, found in producers. So producers means plants. Essentially producers make their own energy from sunlight through photosynthesis. So we could replace, that term there with plants. Ammonium containing molecules in proteins, in consumers. Consumers are things which eat plants, so those would usually be included things like animals. So you could replace that term there, or that box there, with animals. This box here talks about decomposers, and there are saprobiotic or bacteria. And those are our decomposers. Those are the things that break down the living tissue found in things like plants or consumers. And they do that post-death or excretion. So excretion is the removal of waste, essentially, or a removal of a feces or a waste product. And therefore, our decomposers will actually physically break that down. So some of the arrows that we have here, feeding and digestion. This is just showing which direction the nitrogen is going. And in this case, it's going from the producer to the consumer. And so the consumers would be things like animals. So this is where the animals are actually physically eating the plants. Death and death and excretion, which we've gone through. And this bit here to do with decomposers, saprobiotic microorganisms. Now, saprobiotic digestion is a very specific type of digestion. Now, unlike animals, which have a very, very sophisticated digestive system, bacteria are quite simple organisms and they don't have the same level of sophistication. And so what they have to do is they have to find a way to break food down to digest it without the aid of a digestive system. What they do is they secrete enzymes onto dead material. And what that will do is those enzymes will actually break down the ammonium containing molecules or the proteins found within living things, and they will break them down into small enough parts so they can be absorbed by the bacteria. So saprobiotic digestion means for a bacteria to secrete things like enzymes extracellularly. Those enzymes will then break down the proteins, the ammonium containing compounds found within the dead material, and then they can then be absorbed into the bacteria because they've been digested and then be used in any way that the bacteria needs it. So once the decomposers have undergone saprobiotic digestion, they then start to convert some of the ammonium containing molecules into ammonium ions, and they do so through this process called ammonification. Now ammonification is essentially the production of ammonia from organic compounds, organic just meaning living. Some examples are urea, proteins, nucleic acid, all of which, what they have in common is they all of which contain nitrogen. This process is carried out by saprobiotic microorganisms, so bacteria and fungi. And these feed on these and they release ammonium or ammonia into the soil. And then they can be stored in the soil as ammonium ions, which are technically, the chemical formula for that is NH4. So in summary, what we've just looked at in this video is we've gone through and discovered that producers contain ammonium containing molecules, consumers or animals also contain the same, and when they die they have those ammonium containing molecules broken down or digested by decomposers, and those decomposers use saprobiotic digestion. Remember, saprobiotic means for them to excrete enzymes outside of their cells or outside of the cells. They can then digest proteins found within and the dead material, which they can then absorb. Those then are converted into ammonium ions via this process called ammonification. If you join me on the next video, we'll be looking at the top sections here to do with nitrification and denitrification.